The girls in the balcony, I love you. You're wonderful. Boy, the American public, and I thank all the disc jockeys and everybody. I love you so much, and thank you.
Okay, Michael Jackson was injured this evening at the Shrine Auditorium while filming a commercial. He was working with some explosive devices and also smoke, and a mishap occurred. He sustained a burn, which is about the size of your palm, to the back of his head.
Famous singer Michael Jackson was unexpectedly released from a Los Angeles hospital today. Jackson was rushed to a hospital last night after suffering second and third degree burns.
This was the payoff for the fans tonight. That momentary glimpse of superstar Michael Jackson.
I want to make sure he's all right. I want to see him smiling in my face, even though I don't get to see him close up.
...5 million copies for Thriller. Michael Jackson, the number one artist in the world!
For the first time in my entire career, I feel like I've accomplished because I'm in the Guinness Book of World Records.
Reenacting a scene from one of the two spots was Alfonso Ribeiro, star of Broadway's The Tap Dance Kid. It was during the filming of the other commercial in the series that Michael was burned by flying fireworks.
MTV presents another exclusive world premiere commercial? Michael Jackson's Pepsi commercial for the first time anywhere in the world.
Tonight, the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences presents its annual Grammy Awards for artistry and excellence in the field of recorded entertainment of the past year.
Quincy Jones and Michael Jackson.
Yeah!
Beat it, Michael Jackson.
People are entertainers and some people are great entertainers, some people are followers, and some people make the path and are pioneers.
Stay right here, Boogie. Fire!
I made a deal with myself. If I win one more award, which is this award, which is 7, which is a record, I would take off my glasses. And the girls in the balcony.
Now, since Michael Jackson is the proud winner of 8 shiny new Grammys, you might expect the sales of his records to suddenly surge. Sorry. You see, sales have always been up.
His best-selling album is called Thriller, and it could just as easily be his nickname, for Michael Jackson brings a thrill a minute to his millions of fans. Add up the numbers. He is one of the most popular entertainers of all time, and these days, that means that he's also a one-man financial empire.
Every camera in town was poised to drink it all in. It was the appearance of recording star and teenage heartthrob Michael Jackson.
Well, isn't this a thriller?
But there was definitely a serious side to the day, the effort to dissuade teenagers from drinking and driving.
Jackson's voice will be on two radio commercials and two television spots. And that warranted an award for the young, decidedly taciturn entertainer.
I'm very, very honored. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Andrea, a head of state has never attracted so much attention, so much security, and so much excitement. The crowd all throughout this morning kept chanting, "We want Michael. We want Michael."
I'm still shocked when someone comes up to buy the Thriller album. It seems everybody has it already.
Anything with Michael Jackson on it does continue to sell.
I work in a record store, and it still just flies out of the store every week. And we're talking about a record that's a year and a half, almost 2 years old, and people are still freaking out about it.
There have always been fan clubs, Michael's fans more passionate than most. This club calls itself the PYTs.
All Michael Jackson look-alikes, part of a nationwide campaign to find superstar clones for parties and promotions.
It's the Victory Tour, perhaps the biggest in entertainment history.
It's bigger than the Beatles. It's bigger than Presley. It's bigger than anything.
Months pass with nothing to show but ugly headlines documenting a tangled web of battling egos and fights over money and power involving agents, lawyers, and the promoter.
The Elvis.
We're doing it. She brought me on my knees.
Jackson's Victory. On Epic records and cassettes.
Many of Ron Chapman's Dallas listeners agreed, calling in to condemn the Jackson's controversial ticket system, sending in a $120 money order for four tickets, no choice of date or seat, and no guarantee.
A lot of people are having trouble getting tickets. I've asked our promoter to end the mail order ticket system as soon as possible, so that no one will pay money unless they get a ticket. Finally, and most importantly, there's something else I am going to announce today. I want you to know that I decided to donate all my money I make from the performance to charity.
Who would have thought 4 weeks ago they would have even been performing anywhere? But finally, they are, and today, the Jacksons and Kansas City fit together like a hand in glove. And it's the show it seems everyone wants to see.
Come on, Michael Jackson!
Yeah, sorry. Yeah, sorry.
Right. He's gorgeous!
What do you look like?
Good! Yeah. Dark and handsome!
The 120 speakers stacked five stories high get a final sound check.
Two, three.
Nobody in their right mind would miss the Jackson's concert because it's the most spectacular event in entertainment history.
Preparations are well underway tonight for the Jackson's Victory Tour concert in Jacksonville tomorrow night.
We would do about anything to see Michael Jackson.
Can you help but be a Michael Jackson fan? I mean, even if you weren't, you know, everybody else would just, it would sort of be like osmosis, you know?
I love you, Michael.
Love the show. I wish he had been there for maybe 4 more hours.
Jackson's manager quoted the singer's statement.
It saddens me that many actually believe the present flurry of false accusations. To this end, and we do mean end, no, I have never taken hormones to maintain my high voice. No, I have never had my cheekbones altered in any way. No, I have never had cosmetic surgery on my eyes. Yes, one day in the future, I plan to get married and have a family. Any statements to the contrary are simply untrue.
Jackson's spokesman also said the singer will take legal action against anyone who continues to spread this untrue information.
Armed with a court order and a list of offenders, Michael Jackson's men struck without warning. The investigators hired by Jackson missed nothing. They seized bootleg t-shirt transfers. They scooped up thousands of Jackson buttons. They loaded up on t-shirts.
Investigations show that almost everybody is trying to rip off Michael Jackson, from the corner mom and pop store right up to the major retailers like Eaton's and Sears.
Now there's a Michael Jackson hotline with all the inside news.
It's like Michael from head to toe. Put the mic in his hand and he'll steal the show.
I love you, Michael Jackson.
There were more fans on hand and more security personnel than for the unveiling of any other star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame.
If this area does not back up immediately, we will not be able to have the ceremony.
The dedication ceremony caused pandemonium on Hollywood Boulevard when Michael Jackson appeared in front of Man's Chinese Theater. The sidewalk star was unveiled, and police had to hold back the surging crowd. They were barely able to do so.
But the kids were just, he's the most popular performer in the world, and they showed that here today.
Some paid over $700. Some even stood in line for days just waiting to get close to him. Now in a special issue, People magazine takes you even closer. Not just to Michael Jackson, the performer, but Michael Jackson, the person.
Years, and we love you all.